Hello, I'm Joshua Akkerman with Instructional Technology. Today we're going to be going over some basic video production principles. You see, I have a lot of cameras here in front of me. We're going to get to those in a minute. First, here's a quick preview of what we're going to be doing today. First, I will show you the video cameras and other video production equipment that is available for checkout through the CSB+SJU libraries and how to reserve this equipment through the website. Then, we will dive into production. We will dive deeper into each of these, but we'll be talking about framing, lighting, and audio. Lastly, we'll go over how to import your finals using Final Cut Pro. So let's get started with what equipment is available for checkout. Before we get there though, go ahead and reach into your pocket, purse, or book bag, wherever you keep your smartphone and pull it out. This is a great tool you have unlimited access to. It shoots high quality video and photos that you can use in your video project. We do have smartphone accessories like this tripod and smartphone attachment. It just pops on there. We also have microphones you can use with your smartphone, but we'll get to that later in this video. Next in line here, we have our Canon Vixia. This is one of our consumer-grade cameras and is a great option to use for your video project. As we move over here, we start getting into more of our prosumer-grade or more professional-grade cameras. First up is our Canon DSLR cameras. We have two models, the Canon Rebel T3i and the Canon EOS 80D. These are different from our regular video cameras because of the interchangeable lenses that give you more options when shooting. And these are our prosumer video cameras, the Canon XA25 and the Sony PXW-X70. These cameras are more advanced than the Canon Vixias and give you more control over your shooting options. We of course have additional production items like microphones, tripods, and light kits that you can use in tandem with any of these cameras and are available for checkout. So how do you get your hands on these items? They're available for checkout at both Clemens Library at St. Ben's and Elkin Library at St. John's. You can reserve these items through the website one of two ways. First, you can go to the library's website and search for an item you're looking for. In this case, let's look for a Canon Vixia. You can see the first thing that pops up here are the cameras. I'll click on this and you can see all the different Vixias we have available right now. I'll click on the place hold button. I'll go through and fill out this form and then go pick up the camera when I specified. You can also go to the Instructional Technology website and under Equipment Checkout, see all the equipment we have available. On a specific item, you'll see the Place Hold button. I can click on that and then go through the same process. So now that you know what equipment we have available and how to get your hands on it, let's dive in to the production phase. For this demonstration, I'll be using our Canon Vixia. The concepts you'll be learning here can be used across the board with all of our cameras you have available to you. One thing I would like to point out, if you are using your smartphone, though, is to turn the phone. You don't want to shoot video or take photos vertically like this, but instead you want to turn your phone horizontally. This will give you the proper resolution when filming your video and when you go into edit. So, not vertically, horizontally. All right. Back to the Vixia. I would always recommend that you use a tripod or some other form of stabilizer when shooting your video. This will give you a stable shot and you won't have that handheld video moving all over the place look. Now this is a good time to point out that everything I'm going over today are guidelines and not necessarily rules. Meaning, you can break these guidelines if you are doing so for a purpose. So let's go over framing. Framing a shot is very important for your audience. You are filming what they will be seeing later. When framing your shot, you want to follow the rule of thirds. The rule of thirds is pretty simple. Essentially, pretend you are playing tic-tac-toe on your screen. See how it's dividing it into thirds? So how does this help you? When you are framing your shot, you'll want to line up what you are filming on these lines. Horizontal action, like a horizon, can be lined up on the horizontal lines, and vertical action, say someone walking up a sidewalk, can be lined up on the vertical lines. Key components of your shot can be lined up at the four intersecting points. So in this shot, I have lined up the walking person on the right vertical line, my horizon on the top horizontal line, and put her face on the upper right intersecting line, being she is the focus of my shot. This is a great time to bring up headroom and lead room. Headroom is the space between the top of my subject's head and the top of the frame. Not enough headroom will cut off the top of your subject and your shot might look a little crowded. Too much headroom will make your subject look insignificant. This is where the intersection points using the rule of thirds come in. Again, align your subject at one of these intersection points. Now, lead room is the space out in front of your subject. Notice I have them walking into the frame and not off the frame, like this example. Rule of thirds, headroom, and lead room apply to all of your shots from interviews, action, and landscape. Again, these guidelines can be broken to help create suspense in your film. Think of the last horror movie you watched and how certain shots are framed to create a sense of uneasiness. But remember, it must be done intentionally and to enhance your audience's viewing experience. The last thing I want to go over in framing is following the action, and by this, I mean moving the camera to follow what is happening on the screen. There are five key movements to keep in mind: tilting, panning, zooming, dolly, and trucking. Tilting is moving the camera up and down without moving it along another axis. It's much like nodding your head up and down. Panning is moving the camera from left to right without moving it along another axis, much like shaking your head when saying no. Zooming is getting farther away or closer to your subject by changing the focal length of the lens. You can do this by using the zoom rocker on the camera. Dolly movement is moving the camera forward and back. Like zooming, you are moving closer to or farther from your subject. But again, you are physically moving the camera instead of using the zoom rocker. Trucking is like a dolly movement, but instead you are moving from left to right. Again, this is like panning, but you are once again moving the camera itself. Using these five techniques, you can follow the action of your shot. It's good practice to try multiple shots of the same scene as you are learning. Using a different camera movement can give you a different look for your film. Now that we have gone over framing, let's talk about exposure and focus. Exposure is how much light is being let into your camera. When filming, it essentially determines the brightness of your shot. You want your content to be properly exposed. Underexposing your shot will make your shot look dark and you will lose detail in shadowy areas. On the other hand, overexposing your shot will make it too bright and you'll lose detail in the lighted areas. With the cameras that you have available for checkout, like this Canon Vixia, they are set up in full auto mode. This means the camera will automatically determine the exposure based on what you are filming. While this is helpful and will work in most instances, it doesn't always work. Here's an example. We are conducting an interview here where it is very bright in the background because we are filming against a window. If we set the exposure by tapping a certain part of the screen on the camera, say the background, you'll notice that our subject becomes dark and hard to see. If we set the auto exposure on the subject, the background becomes too bright. In this instance, the best bet would be to find a new location for your interview and not film against the window. We do have light kits available for checkout, exactly like our cameras. Using lighting can bring your shot up to the proper exposure. You can use lighting from a multitude of sources, including natural lighting, mainly the sun, one of our checkout light kits, or by using a reflector to bounce light in the direction you want. Let's go back to our interview example. We have switched places now, so the subject is facing the window and the camera's back is to the window. We're using the natural light from the window to light our subject. But what if you didn't have a window? This is where our light kits come in. Here we are in our video studio and you can see just using the overhead lighting, our subject is still kind of dark. Now, we can set up one of our checkout light kits using a tripod, and here you can see the difference. Now, our subject is properly exposed. Now I'm going to quickly go over three-point lighting. This is what you'll ideally want to use when lighting your scene or interview. First up is the key light. This is the main light that lights up your subject, but you notice it's casting shadows on the side of their face. Insert the fill light. This lights up the other side of the subject face and fills in those shadows. Lastly is the backlight. This light gently lights up the back of the subject to separate them from the background. Now you will always need three lights to achieve three-point lighting. Let's go back to our interview example. You'll see we have just one of our checkout lights that we're using as the key light and using natural light from the window as the fill. The room is bright enough that we can get away without using a backlight. Now you want to match the color temperature of lights you are using. On the checkout light kits, there is a knob that changes the color of the light from a red tint to a blue tint. Typically, natural light will be a blue tint, so you'll want to adjust your light kit to match. If you're in a setting like this quad building hallway where the lighting is more of a red look, you can adjust the light kit to match. Now let's talk about focusing. Again, the Canon Vixia is set to full auto mode and will automatically focus. See the square following our subject? This is the auto focus, so pay attention to this when filming to ensure your shot stays in focus. You can also manually set your focus by tapping the screen on what part you want it to focus on. All right, so we've gone over framing, exposure, lighting, and focusing. The last thing that we need to talk about is sound. Consider sound your handwriting on a paper that you write. If your audience can't read your handwriting, they can't read your paper. Same concept with sound. If your audience can't understand what they are hearing, they can't watch the video. There are four different microphones you can possibly be using with our cameras: the onboard microphone, a lapel or handheld microphone, or a shotgun microphone. Let's hear the differences in all of these. First is the onboard microphone. This is the default the Vixias and phones will use when you start recording. Michael is here to help me out. Michael, can you tell me your name and what you do here on campus?
Well, yes, of course. My name is Michael Pineda and I'm the video production specialist for Johnny Benny Media.
Now, I would recommend using a wired lapel microphone like the one I'm wearing right now. Again, here's Michael and you should be able to hear the difference between the two.
Well, yes, of course. My name is Michael Pineda. I am the video production specialist for Johnny Benny Media.
Wired lapel microphones work best for stationary shots and interviews. Next is our shotgun microphones. These are best used when trying to capture multiple people and action shots. Here is an example so you can hear the difference.
Well, yes, of course. My name is Michael Pineda and I am the video production specialist for Johnny Benny Media.
You'll notice it sounds close to the lapel microphone option. Hear all the examples of the different microphones again so you can hear the difference between all of them.
Well, yes, of course. My name is Michael Pineda and I'm the video production specialist for Johnny Benny Media.
Well, yes, of course. My name is Michael Pineda and I am the video production specialist for Johnny Benny Media.
Well, yes, of course. My name is Michael Pineda and I am the video production specialist for Johnny Benny Media.
During your pre-production meetings with your group, it is a good idea to talk about what equipment you'll need for the shooting you'll be doing. Always remember to test your equipment before you leave for a shoot or interview. This can be done quickly in your dorm room or any other location. Simply plug in the microphone, turn it on, plug in your headphones, and talk into the mic. Always remember to monitor your audio with headphones. It is the best and easiest way to know your camera is capturing the audio that you want.